Hello. Good morning. Good evening. Good afternoon. Welcome to Jessica Payne Live. I'm your host, Jessica Payne. Sorry to be a couple minutes late. I had to pour my coffee. You know how it is. Welcome. Come on in. Sit down. Thanks for joining me live. Who do we have here? Oh, I've got some familiar faces. Looks like we've got Fahimu. We've got Teresa. Hi, everyone. How? We've got Nancy here too. Hello. Today we're going to talk about, you might have heard or seen on Pinterest or Instagram, this whole think rule where you're asking a series of questions. Is it true? Is it kind? Everyone from, Oprah tends to quote this rule. Teachers, I had a hard time finding the original source of this whole thought process. So I couldn't exactly credit it. But what I like about it is you're hearing it a lot as advice people are trying to hand around social media just so that we can be kinder to each other. And I thought, that these are good rules. These are questions to ask in terms of making sure that our storytelling is authentic. So today we're going to talk about, again, the whole reason is to put purpose behind your time on social media. Maybe you are planning your programs right now. Maybe you're taking a look at the performance of your social media strategy. Maybe you're just starting to get it going. Maybe you're somewhere in between. But in terms of the, data shows that storytelling works on social media, especially if you're more authentic. And I thought if that word authentic intimidates you or is a little bit too confusing, you could go through the same exercise that you've probably seen before to ensure that your storytelling is not only authentic, but it actually benefits others when they read it. Last week, we talked about the type of content that we talked about emotion, and we talked about using more positive or pragmatic or solution-oriented content rather than negative or fear-based. It's kind of along the same lines. And part of this is just my public service announcement for us just to create more positive, helpful content on social media. I think the big shift right now, which you've seen, people are running away from social media because it can be a highly toxic place on certain channels, and then they're embracing other channels. So an example is a lot of people have left Facebook. A lot of people are starting to come back. A lot of people ran away to Instagram to escape, but they're finding it's a little bit of there's a limitation in the types of content, so they're coming back. People are starting to spend more time on LinkedIn. So I think people are starting to kind of assess their experience on social media. And then for if you run a business or a nonprofit, or maybe you use social media for your brand, we have to keep that in mind. Let's not be annoying. Last week I talked about let's market our businesses without being pushy. That's what this week is all about. What's going on, Teresa? How are you? Welcome, welcome. Teresa, did you find last week's show helpful? Curious. I know we talked a little bit about content. And have you guys seen this? I'm going to see if I can share my desktop screen to see if I can actually show it to you. And I honestly just took an image from the interwebs. So if you guys bear with, I'll show you what I'm looking at. Give a second. Can you guys see that? Let me make myself small. Other way around. There we go. You're literally looking at my desktop. So you've seen this graphic before, maybe. Look how tiny I am. How sweet. How about we share it? Boom. So you've probably seen this graphic before, right? Boom. How about I just share the screen with it? Before you speak, think. Teresa, you're a teacher. Maybe you've actually used this in the classroom. You ask these questions. Is it T? Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? Is it kind? I think that there's no better rule book for social media strategy right now for a series of questions you can ask yourself. Is my content authentic? Because you could literally go through every single one of these questions. And if you can answer yes, then you can rest assured that your content is actually sound. It's helpful. That second one is so true. So we're going to just tick our way through these boxes today for the purpose of today's show. But if you have any questions, let me know. I think any one of us, we can apply this to our life, to our business, to our relationships. Basically, I think why that works is it's about conversation. It's about relationships. And social media, that's what it is. Social media is just a mechanism. It's a tool. It's not magic. It's just a system like anything else. at the root of it, you can make it work for you if you use the power of language, right, to build trust. That's all social media is. You get people to trust you and your brand. Chances are, data has shown they're more than likely to spend their time and money with you. Maybe you don't, maybe you're not selling anything. Maybe you run a nonprofit or you're just trying to get your brand out there. Same, same. So I'm gonna look down to my right because that's where I've got my questions. So I'm not ignoring you guys. Teresa saying, yes, used to have it on my wall. There you go, exactly. So that helps me. Nothing better than hearing a teacher tell me she uses it, right? I'm so glad. And Teresa, I'm curious to hear how you would actually use it in your teaching. And if anything stood out, I know you work with kids. I'm curious, would any of these stand out more to the kids than others? I'm just fascinated to learn that. Teresa's saying, the problem with social media is that most people don't care if it's helpful, inspiring, something positive, or if it's necessary or kind. That's a society problem, not a social media problem. I couldn't agree more. I couldn't agree more. That doesn't mean that we... So when I hear that, I agree. But the second thing is, we use social media casually too. I think the thing that stands out to me is when a brand is like this. So if I hear, when you say most people don't care, I think, great, my opportunity is actually just be myself and tick all these boxes. And I know I'm going to be separate out from the others. I think people are pretty jaded by social. So yeah, I think that just means there's more of an opportunity for us to stand out. Wouldn't you agree? Did you hear that? We've got a studio cat today. She's loud and proud. Loved last week's show, and I'm super excited about today's as well. Yay, I'm so glad. So, so happy. We might even have a drive-by with Lady. Do you want to walk into frame? Let's go. You might see a tail. Oh, good. Right at the center of my keyboard. Excellent. No better place for a cat than right here during a broadcast. Perfect. I wouldn't be authentic or true if I didn't admit. She's like right here. So you might see a tail. How's everybody doing? We've got some weird weather going on here in California, if you guys care. We've got a weird fire that's flared up and it's overcast. It's the end of the world here in Los Angeles. We can't see the sun. Back to school. Shout out to all my parents out there and teachers. How are you guys doing? I know it's been a crazy couple weeks. Teresa's saying, I use it as a conflict resolution platform. I would inject it into an interaction between kids and ask these questions to guide them to communicate, engage positively. That is awesome. I think if people are wondering how to actually use this, if you have a product that solves a problem or a solution, that is actually the perfect case study for you to use. Like, use Teresa's idea, if you don't mind, Teresa. A real teacher uses it, that you can actually use these. Yes, Kitty. We'll see if she'll grace us with her actual presence today. She likes to be a phantom and lurk. Okay, how about we just tick through these questions? Take a look at, and if it helps, open up your own, don't go away. Open up a separate window, turn on your, grab your mobile device and have your social channel. Pick one of the channels you're on so that you can take a look at the last 3 to 5 posts you did. Maybe it's LinkedIn, maybe it's your last tweets or whatever. Have them up and let's go through this criteria and let's just see. Now, half of what you do is probably your own content. We talked last week about sharing others. So ideally, when you're sharing others or maybe you're sharing articles, take a look at that stuff too. Just take a look at the last week or two of your social content so we can take a look at this and what you're saying. Here's another thing. If you learn better by example, which I do, after this exercise, or if you can multitask, go pick a social media channel of a brand or organization that you really admire and open them up. If that helps you actually learn, maybe you don't have a lot of social content, have something up that you can take a look at. The first thing we can say is it true? I think the best brands know that to tell the truth now, transparency is everything. We all know we can all smell a fake, especially millennials. I think we're all used to being sold to. I think politics has made us extremely skeptical and jaded. But as humans, we know when we're being told the truth. And when I say the truth, it doesn't mean the exact opposite of lie. I mean, the truth is when you admit a mistake, when things aren't exactly perfect, when people might stutter on camera, or it might be shaky, or there might be technical glitches. Live streaming is a great example of authenticity and true. Other examples of truth can be, last week I saw a live stream of a buddy of mine. He runs an organization. He travels around the country. It's his own business. I think it's called Blue Collar Marketing, and he provides marketing strategies and solutions, among other things, for organizations that have, I think, mostly a blue collar workforce. And he was talking about, I think he was looking to buy a house, and I think the deal fell through, and I don't think he got it. He was really bummed. So it was his live stream for his business, but his platform is about, this was actually perfect for his platform but he was being extremely open and vulnerable. He could tell he was frustrated. And I think it was a beautiful live stream. He was being true. So truth can be just open, I think, as well. It doesn't mean you have to air your dirty laundry. I know that's, privacy is your thing. You can keep 90% of your life private, 99% of your life private, and the other 1% on social. But think about, is it true? So not just telling the truth, what about your life can you bring forward in your own lived experience, your own story? We've talked about it before. That can kind of prove why you're here. Maybe it's the story that convinced you to start your thing, launch your thing, change your career, whatever. What about your story is true? Because again, I think that gives people context. It builds trust. And then they can see, wow, Teresa's exactly where I was. I can trust her. I can spend my time and money with her. Is it true? We do here in Michigan. In the last 5 minutes, the sun is gone and the sky looks like it's about to explode. You guys have your own ecosystem out there in Michigan. I love it. H, is it helpful? Let's just go down the boxes. Again, if you're just joining or if you're listening over on the podcast or maybe on YouTube, thank you. Please subscribe. We are talking about these, the five THINK questions. You've probably seen a variation of these somewhere. I'll put them in the descriptor if you want to know what I'm talking about. If you're actually watching the live right now on the replay, you'll see it. If you're listening, just look in the descriptor for what I'm talking about. We talked about, is it true? Is it helpful? This is your biggest opportunity to make your social media content stand out. And when I say social media, I mean storytelling. If you come from a place of service, which I've said before, when you're trying to help people fix, like right now, I would say my show is framed in, I try to be helpful. Every week, I just don't come and ideally annoy you. I'm hoping that I come every week with the purpose of trying to just teach you something. And listen, listening is a big part of it. I wouldn't be true if I didn't admit I need to listen more. So helpful. If you can help improve someone's life in a matter of minutes on social media or seconds, that's all people are looking. They go to social media for two reasons, to escape mostly and to find out information. Remember, the internet came along because people wanted to start to find information and save information and share it. So if you can point people in the direction of a solution or overcoming a challenge, or maybe just brightening their day or pointing them to the next phase of whatever it is to help them get over or to get through what they're doing, ideally through your business, that's extremely helpful. And I think less is more. Do it quickly, do it clearly, we've talked about before, and do it in a way that doesn't ask too much of them. And then you're golden. People will come back. Just do that consistently. Consistency is helpful too. Meeting people where they're at. So I'm here every Tuesday. People, I think, know that now. If I was at different times of the week or not every single week, I think that would be confusing. Other helpful things are short videos, live streams, ebooks, maybe a free course or a discount. Think of how you can help people. Where are they at? Is money tight for your audience right now? Are they way too busy? Is short and sweet better? Think about that. Okay, is it inspiring? What up, D? We've got Diana Willis in the house, entrepreneur as well. Diana's been embracing live streaming. And D, you've been very true and authentic in your posts and videos. So you're a great example of that. You know, business is hard. You know, I have some sleepless nights. I'm nervous on camera sometimes. Some shows are better than others. You know what's really funny? When I think I have a really bad show, that's typically when I get the best feedback. And they're like, great show. And I'm like, I don't know what happened. Probably because it's true. I don't know. Guys, follow Diana if you want. She's an entrepreneur, cosmetic company. You do these great transformation videos where you can demonstrate the product. She's a great example of that, you guys. Entrepreneur. You're welcome. I only am reflecting what I see. So you guys, again, if you want to learn by example, if you don't follow everyone that kind of shows up on my show every week, you should, because these are people that, and they're not just clients of mine, you guys. Seriously, these are people that are, I know every single one of you have got, you're incredibly smart, intelligent, you learn by example, you're running your own business or you're starting your own thing, and you inspire me. So you guys, again, something that's helpful, maybe inspiring. That was like a totally natural segue. Follow everyone, either now or after the show. Just write down everyone's handle or click on them and follow them. Because I think every single one of you guys are running a business. If I can scroll. Yeah. And last week too, we had a lot of people on last week. Okay, so we are going through the five questions you can ask. Specifically, if you're trying to make your social media content more authentic, not just for the sake of it, but we all know that the more authentic and true and powerful it is, the more people will actually consume it, engage with it, and ideally engage with you. The third one is it inspiring? So I just talked about something inspiring in this space is every single one of you that show up each week. And when I hear that a couple of you are syncing up behind the scenes, that makes me happy. Half of what I do is just connecting people. That's fulfilling to me. Is it inspiring? Again, last week we talked about the power of emotion, awe, humor, delight. Positive emotions convert or engage people three times more on social media. That's just the way it is. While fear and negative-based emotion might stick with us longer because they probably have triggered something or annoyed us, that doesn't mean we've necessarily engaged with it. I typically run away from social media content that's like that, but it's the videos that I watch all the way through. It's the people that I actually talk to and engage with on social media that tend to have more inspiring content. So what do I mean by inspiring? Let's say you're in real estate. You're like, how can that be inspiring? Again, what you want to do is, and you probably do this in your business organization, tell a story, tell a transformation, show a before and after, point people to how they can not just benefit from what you're doing or selling, but show them a case study. Show them a 60-second spot of something you've gone through. Again, this can just be your own journey. I think, again, if you can inspire people, I think people get inspired when they can relate. When you give them hope to take the same journey you have or take the next step. I think leading up to making it inspiring can be telling a true story, a challenge you've overcome, maybe a way that you can relate with them. Maybe give them the tools, make it helpful. I think just giving people tools can inspire. I've given out everything from free quizzes to eBooks. I've asked questions. Sometimes I'll just give out a link to just some fun things, which if you wanna go through a fun exercise, if you type in the word images, if you message my page the word images, you have to type it in the, you have to message me images in Messenger, you'll get a little thing. Giving people just little tools that save them time, that inspires them. That gets them to move to the next phase. Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? And is it necessary? This is a fun one. Yes, people get inspired when they can relate. Totally. That's all this is about. Right, Dee? Like, there are people that use social media to constantly talk about themselves. And that's cool. That's not me. I'd rather like turn on social, if you can turn it on, and see someone I can relate with. Because I'm gonna remember you, I'm not gonna remember the other people. You know, there's just too much out there. All right, is it necessary? This is fun. A lot of stuff that's posted on social media is not necessary. It's to me, personally, it's lazy. And I think it plays into those primal fear-based or negative or scarcity emotions that I think maybe work for a certain segment of marketing, but for every single one of you, it doesn't. You can still talk about how you were afraid. You can still talk about overcoming something. You can still talk about how you didn't have something and now you have it. It's different. Is it necessary? I think one of the biggest challenges I hear from folks is I need a framework. And I think what I hear when you say that is you guys are overwhelmed. I get overwhelmed too. Social media is a big giant. You have businesses to run. You have organizations to run. Maybe you need donors. You're focused on other stuff. Social media is like the 83rd thing you have to do. Is it necessary? I think giving yourself a framework, literally telling yourself, I'm going to post this many times a week, 3 times a week on Facebook, once every day on Twitter. Like, carve out your time, use Outlook, give yourself rules and boundaries when it comes to creating your social media content. That can help you ask this question, is it necessary? So if you know, like, well, I'm limiting myself to 3 posts a week, is this necessary? No, my other 3 posts are, I think, way more helpful, way more inspiring, way more valuable. Is it necessary? This is another good question to ask. Maybe if you're trying to, maybe you're solid on the social media content piece and you're like, I need to engage more, or I need to follow influencers or comment more. If you spend any time on Instagram, you know when people are using robots to comment, nice post, or just a heart. There's a lot of fake commenting out there, and it's really frustrating, especially when you think you're engaging with a real person. Is it necessary? This is a good question to ask when you're like, should I comment or not? If you are ever moved in any way by anyone's social media post, comment. That's like my rule right now, because I think every comment, every genuine comment, makes a huge difference. I think especially to people that, you know, aren't celebrities or aren't influencers, and people always comment back and, you know, do that from a place of being like totally true and helpful and authentic. Don't do it just to get a follow back, but chances are you probably will get a follow back. I've been having a lot of fun playing around with that this week. Is it necessary? And here's another thing that I've been wrestling with. Is it necessary? Okay, so let's say you read someone else's post and it triggers something, or you feel you have to insert your opinion. We all do it. That's what makes social media work. Going through these 5 questions, I think, is at the nut of that. If you can answer yes, then I think proceed with the comment. If you can't answer yes to all of these, then don't proceed with the comment. This is really interesting. Raise your hand if you spend any time on LinkedIn. We thought trolls were only limited to Twitter and Facebook. They're showing up on LinkedIn now, which is hilarious because, you know, people can tell where you work. People can, you know, your employees are on there. It's weird. Like yesterday I saw this guy, I won't get into it, but he was literally looking for a job, and he just went off on this whole feminist thing. Typical of the times, but it's like, so it was him and about 10 of us women. And we were kind of looking at each other like, does he know that he's looking for a job and his employer can actually see these comments? It was almost funny because he was completely, anyway, is it necessary? He answered no to that, yet he still proceeded to comment, and we burned it down. So anyway, tangent. So when you're commenting, when you're engaging, that's a whole other social media strategy. You can also use this rule too. Does any of this make sense, y'all? I'm a little pre-coffee. I'll get more in me. We can do a whole, maybe that's what we do next week. We can do a whole show on, okay, so you guys let me know in the comments. Would it be helpful if I did a show on, because we talk about content a lot, on commenting as a social media strategy? Because it is. Let me know in the comments, like type yes or type no, type I'm all set. Would that be helpful? I've been spending more time on LinkedIn. So you guys remember a couple weeks ago, and I'll post it again today, I shared my quiz. How many of you guys have taken it, by the way? 10 questions, 20 minutes tops. I went through my own assessment and I realized, wow, I really haven't been active on LinkedIn. So for the past couple weeks, I've really dialed up my time. I've just spent more dedicated time on LinkedIn, and a lot of it is commenting, and I've learned a lot. I've commented before, like especially on other social media channels, but like LinkedIn is an excellent opportunity. So would you guys, tangent, but would you guys find that helpful if I did a show maybe next week on commenting, how that can be a social media strategy? Let me know. I don't think commenting, but engaging or getting engagement. Yeah. Teresa, yeah, for sure. I think the whole idea of reciprocity, of like you have to pay it forward, social media content is just 50% of the house. And maybe I don't talk about this this much. The other side, the most successful brands on social media, not just post content that's theirs or other people's, they engage with other people. So that could be tagging or commenting. Yeah. So, okay, there, I'm being true. Maybe I haven't spoken about that a lot. So maybe we can make that next week's topic. But let me know. I want to make sure that this place is true, helpful, inspiring, necessary, and kind for you. D, Diana saying engagement would be something helpful for me more so than commenting. Okay. Teresa and Diana, can you think of an example question in terms of like, what about engagement should I talk about more? Any and all questions are, there's no right or wrong question. Like, I'd love to know right now in terms of engagement, because that's a big word, right? So ask a question if you don't mind in the comments or DM me. Teresa's saying, I engage a lot in other people's groups, but in my own, I have lurkers. Totally creepified. Yeah, you know what? Some people will never engage actively on social media, and it's annoying, frustrating. However, that doesn't mean that they aren't consuming your content. That doesn't mean that they don't trust you. They just might take a longer time to touch the button, pull the trigger, whatever it is you're doing. Some people just take a longer time. Some people just may not ever have an intention of buying, donating, subscribing, whatever it is you do, but they still like you and they still follow you. I have people in my group that I know are never going to be technically customers of mine, but gosh, they've liked a post, or maybe they might even share it, or they might reach out to me after. And that's okay. I think the magic is knowing who your lurkers are and honoring that, and then focusing on working with folks who might actually be more interested in you. This is totally true. Teresa has a great question here. How can I encourage people to engage with me in my content more instead of just lurking? Yeah. All right, we'll make that a focus of next week, but we can talk about it now. First of all, go through these five questions. You can't make anyone do anything, because if they're on social media in your group, they're probably doing three other things. They might even be on their mobile device. They're extremely distracted. Again, social media is just one piece of your whole marketing mix. It's not a magic wand. You can't force lurkers. And when she says lurkers, you guys, these are people who are more casual. They're reactive. They don't ever engage with your content, yet they might follow your group. You're like, you never say hi. There could be a variety of factors why they don't engage. You know, social media is a broadcast tool. Some people don't want to engage because they don't want to broadcast that they're engaging. I don't think that's the case for you, Teresa. But again, so you can't make people who've never engaged with you engage. I think if they've established that pattern, there's really nothing you can do for that. And I'm going to tell you right now, they're not your target audience. You want to focus on people who are engaging at this point. The people that choose to engage are pretty obvious out the gate. You might have people that immediately like, we all do it. We start a group or we share something, and we've always got that sort of that handful of people who always interact. They like, share, comment. They'll shoot you a little email. That's our best audience. And again, they might not even be clients or customers, but these are your advocates. You really want to nurture those relationships. But if you've got people who've never engaged with you and they've followed you for a while, don't waste your time, because you're not going to convince them. Yep, if you haven't convinced them yet, there's nothing you can do magically to do that. But what you can do is, if you're somewhere in between, you might want to think about that helpful, that H. What can you provide that is helpful? Maybe some tools. You basically need to entice people a little bit out of their busy lives to engage with you. And you can do little things. You can run a poll. You could run a contest, incentive. You'd be surprised how many people come out of the woodwork to enter a quiz or a contest just for like an iTunes gift card. Like, it's crazy. You could do a giveaway time to the time of year. Halloween's coming up. Crazy in the holidays. Who doesn't like free stuff? You could do a survey and incentivize people. But just be smart and hand over, give things to people that could actually entice them. So for me, I run quizzes, I do eBooks, I do free downloads. And that gives me, I'm not just doing that just to give you content. For me, obviously, I want to engage with you. That to me tells me who out of my group is more likely to maybe have more of a conversation about social media than folks who just like free stuff. Yeah. So I think offering people more of a variety, and I have to say, supporting everything you're doing on social media with other places, your website, your blog, your newsletter, and offline. And I know you're not going to like that answer. I've made the decision that a bot might be better than a group. Interesting. So guys, for you just joining, a bot is a chat bot, a messenger bot. Could be. Let's watch this space. Teresa, I'm actually really curious to hear how you're going to use it. Guys, if you're curious to see how a bot works, go to my website. You'll see one right on my homepage. I'll put the link and the URL after this. A lot of people are like, what's a bot? They're annoying. Are they Russia? They're not, all of them. If you want to actually see how Messenger bot can be cool and have personality in it, visit the one on my homepage. Which if you want to go right now, it's jessicapayne.us, but don't go, stick around. I'll put the link in the group. Bingo, they just watch. They never ask questions or offer ideas. Teresa, that's not your audience. You got to move on. You're never going to convince those people. Yeah. But it's important. You might get one or two, but that's not your warm audience. But to be fair, it's like your social media strategy has changed a little bit, and that's okay. Yeah. Your focus now is to kind of pull from that group, if any, and start to really nurture with people who have interacted with you. What up, Catherine Sears, Lent. How are you? Thanks for joining. We're talking about the 5 rules. This is probably wicked familiar if you've spent any time on social media. I'm actually using this to frame social media strategy. And just to honor everyone's time, I want to make sure we get to the last of these questions. But if you have questions on it, we just got some. I think the focus of next week is going to be about engagement. So thank you guys. Again, this is listening. I wouldn't be helpful or inspiring or necessary if I didn't listen. So thanks for the feedback. D is saying, I get a lot of engagement when it's about my family and kids, but when it comes to my business, it's like crickets. Word. Totally. Here's a question, D. Are you posting on a business page or your profile or both? I think this is something we all share. How do you make the jump from that personal network to a larger network? We can talk about that next week for sure. You're not alone. Creating an actual business page can help you create an entity that is separate from. And after you do that, you might want to consider a couple of things. Post a few times on your personal profile that you've created a page, that everything you do for your business is going there. Use a combination of those profiles. You know, I've got friends and family who, again, they're never going to be clients. They're my biggest advocates, but they're like not my customers. So how do you, you know, their role, it's just knowing their role. Their role for you is probably just going to be, you know, tooting the horn, you know, hitting the chest, like being your biggest cheerleaders. But you got to make sure that you are in front of people who are actually going to probably buy from you than just cheerlead. So one of the strategies you could do is create a page, get your biggest advocates to follow that page so that they can still cheer you on, but now more in a place that you can market directly to your customers. And you might want to think about running a Facebook ad, especially going into the holidays, to get your followers in that group up. Combination, so that, you know, 3 months from now, you might have a good 1,000 followers or so that are more likely to buy from you. That's a real challenge, and we've all been there. Yeah, for sure. Is that helpful? Is that helpful? Is it inspiring? Both. Yeah. Got it. Yeah. Sometimes it just takes time too. I have found every time that, like, I'll post on my personal profile, which is actually very rare now about my business. Sometimes I'll do it accidentally. I'll get like a lot of people watching, or I'll get a lot of advocacy. And I'm like, you know, I should keep them informed. And I should remind them that I have a business page, because wouldn't that activity on my business page be that much better? Yeah, combination of both. Where did we leave off? Is it kind, I think, was the last one. Okay, is it kind? Again, I think this is your biggest opportunity to just separate yourself from every other person. Whatever kind means to you. Kind to me means compassionate. It means ticking all of these boxes. It means respecting other people's time. It means asking for feedback and being open to all feedback. It means not being a jerk. It means not picking fights, not trolling others, leading by example. The same things we learn in like elementary school, right? Or church, or wherever you learn your sort of the ground rules of just being a kind human. Whatever our parents taught us, probably. Is it kind? So is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? Is it kind? Take a look at, if you've got it, your social media content over the past couple weeks, take a look at your content. Or if you don't really have a lot to look at, pick your favorite brand or maybe even a competitor if you want. Look at their social media content. and see if they're able to tick all these boxes. And if they are, I mean, I think this is a great place to start if you're wondering, how can I make my content more powerful, more authentic? We all know that the more authentic and powerful social media content is, the more it actually drives action. So the whole purpose of today's show is to, like, let's translate what you're putting out on social media into stuff that actually gets other people to do what you want them to do. And it starts in being, I think, a good citizen of social media. It doesn't take much. Most of it is just yourself, but hopefully this little exercise can help round it out. And at the end of the day, just put more of you in your content without being pushy, without being salesy, connecting the dots, just being your true self. Every time I watch your show, it's a reminder that I need to talk to you. You always have great tactic ideas, a lot of ahas. Oh, thanks, Teresa. I appreciate that. That tells me I think I've been helpful today. I do the show with a great deal of love, but also I'm not attached to it. I treat it as, like, I guess, a mini classroom. So thanks for your feedback today, you guys, on engagement. I will absolutely make that the focus of next week's show. If you want me to troubleshoot or workshop something specific, you can keep it anonymous. Shoot me a question on here, or honestly, like Diana, Teresa, who else is on here, Catherine. If you have a question around engagement, I will literally just spend the next show going through your questions and we can workshop it. We went a little bit into strategy today. That's a good example. How do I make the jump from just getting family and friends to actually getting customers? That's a great example. Think about what else you want me to talk about, because I will absolutely troubleshoot it. But in the meantime, a couple of things, you guys. Again, if you want to see an example of a bot at work, we talked a little bit about bots. Go to the homepage of my website, which I'll put a link right now in, jessicapayne.us. More importantly, I really want you guys to take that. It's a free quiz. It's in my blog. You don't have to download anything. Take your social media wellness quiz, which I'm going to put a link right after the show in it. Just wait like a second, refresh your page. If you haven't already, 10 questions. They're really designed to have you just visit your social media, get real about where you're at, and get that framework going so that you can really get some great results for the rest of the year. We have plenty of opportunity this year for you to make some huge changes and to improve your social media. Plenty of time. We're not even in September yet, you guys. We will next week. Cool beans? Was this helpful? Was this inspiring? Let me know. I will... I'll post this little image. You can find little variations of it, but it's one of my favorites. It just stuck out to me. I think I hear it all the time. I try to use it in life and business, and I think it's pretty easy to remember. What do you think? Who else do we have? We have Rob Wheat in the house. You guys, if you don't know already, I'm going to jump over to Instagram and give the quick highlights if you're on Insta. Follow me there. You can follow me, listen to me on the podcast. That's actually getting pretty popular, which is amazing, which is hilarious. It's just the audio version of the show. So wherever you're at, find me, subscribe, like, share, tell your friends. That'd be great. Definitely helpful and inspiring. I'm glad, Diana. I'm happy about that. You guys are like my best examples. This was great. Thanks so much, Teresa. I appreciate it. All right, you guys, I'm going to let you go. The links are coming in the comments right now. If you have any questions, let me know. Next week, I'm going to talk about engagement. Think about your questions. Let me know. Other than that, you guys have a great week. Happy social media content writing. I'll look for you guys out in the ether. I'll be commenting on your pages, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Thanks for...
The podcast you just heard was published with Anchor. Got something you want to say to the creator of this show? Send them a voice message using the Anchor app, free for iOS and Android.